Hi everyone, I'm Glory and welcome back to today's message. And I want to share some word of God to you and from chapter 7 of Ezra, verse 10. And in this chapter, it is talking about how Ezra is trying to rebuild the new temple at Jerusalem. And in here, I see something valuable and I want to share that with you today. I want to say the three things that is the main thing that you need as you start as a Christian and as you start as a teen, like grow as you grow older too. And if you're starting in this new life in Christianity, this can also help. So I want to talk about it. So the first one is called devoted. And this devoted is really hard. And it's hard for humans too because we lost interest from one thing to another. It happens to all of us. We have an interest in one thing and it's for a moment, just like a while, and then later on you lost interest or you just don't care anymore and you moved on. And this devotion is really, really important in Christian life. Devoting to God might be hard sometimes. And there are challenges that you meet. There are some things that you have to face. And sometimes I also have to face this at school or at home or just my normal life. And it can be either social media or either friends or being at school and studies and choices that you have to make in life. And it's just normal things that you see. And sometimes we can think, oh, it won't hurt to try. I mean, we're teenagers. Yes, but doesn't mean that it's just because you're a teenager, you get to try it. And God, there's things that you know that when you do it, it's gonna cost you and it's going to affect you in some way, but you still do it. There are times in life you have to make these decisions, and sometimes we often used to think it doesn't hurt to try. But know that we're not normal teenagers or not normal people. We are the chosen people of God. And we can't do normal things. We have to be extraordinary. So, as my advice to you right now, be devoted to God. Sometimes it might be hard. Sometimes you might not even want to try. Sometimes when you wake up, you feel like, you know, why am I even here today? Or when you open the Bible, you might feel like, oh, yeah, why am I reading it? I mean, this is already read. I already know the stories, but that doesn't mean you have to stop reading it. Yes, you know the story, but to know more from the story, you have to read the story again, because I've learned this while I was at school. As you write in literature, as you read and write, you can see new things from this writing, because the author wants you to see something, but sometimes people see another thing. And it often happens with so many situations in life, because people may let you see one thing, but you might see another thing. And everyone is in a different perspective because everyone is a different person. And this is it. God don't just want to see you looking at one specific thing from the story. He wants to see you looking from everywhere, looking from different perspectives. And that will help you keep on devoting, because every day you expect to find a new thing from the Bible or new thing while reading the book of God, and just while reading it, and then you'll see so many new things, and that will help you being devoted. And number two I want to say is dependence. And as humans, we need to be dependent. We are dependent one way or another. And sometimes we like to let our ego get in the way and just, you know what, I don't need, I can do it alone, I can do this myself. And there are so many times in life that you might think like that, because we think that we can do this alone, or if somebody see us doing this alone, they would think we're strong. No, if you ask for help, or in any way, if you ask God for help, He will come help you. He will come help you in any way. Because if you ask for help, that is what makes you stronger. Because people will see you that you're not afraid to ask for help. And that's really special nowadays, because nobody wants to ask for help. They think that makes them weak. That asking for help thing makes them weak, but it doesn't. It just makes you grow, and it just makes you seem you're growing stronger and stronger in this spiritual and physical life. And I'm asking you to depend on God, depend on what He has to say to you, depend on what He has planned for you, and depend on everything that He will do for you, and trust Him. And we have this thing that in the back of our mind, that thing will stop us in trusting people. And everyone have stranger danger. Everyone thinks that strangers are dangerous, but nobody knows each other's stories. You might see a stranger walking past your street and you will just think, oh, this is stranger danger. I can't talk to him, I'll just go on my way. Like, if they come and ask you and give you candies, that's what I've heard since I was young. Do not accept candies from strangers, they are danger. So everyone have gone through that phase from our parents telling us, don't trust strangers. But do we really know the strangers that is in front of us? And God, when we started to believe in Him, when we come to this Christianity, and when we first grow in this Christianity, God is a stranger to us. We know that He do great things, but He's still a stranger to us. But that doesn't mean He is danger. As we learn more of this God, we're gonna see that He's almighty and He helps us in every way possible. And when we depend on Him, our lives become easier. And just like that, when you first met your best friend, you might feel, oh, she's a stranger, I don't know her. And as you grow in your relationship with your friendship, and you grow knowing them, and you grow knowing what they're really like, you learn to love them. And just like that, as you know more of God, you learn to love Him, and you learn to depend on Him, and you learn to open up to God. And that's what I want you to do. Be devoted to God, be dependent on God. And the last thing I want to tell you guys is to be determined. And it's determination is just like devotion, but determination, it's also another thing. Devotion is just being devoted to one thing. Determination is this mindset of doing this until the end. And you might go off track sometimes, but our determination in our heart will help us go through to the end. Because not everyone have goals in their lives. And I have met so many people, they are older than me and they're much more of an adult than me, but they still don't have any goals in their life. And I want to encourage every teen, every adult watching this right now, I want to encourage you guys to have a goal in your life. May it be small, may it be big, just try to have a goal. And if you reach that goal, try to have another goal, because every day is a battle. It's your battle. You have to win it with God. And you wake up in the morning and just say to God, God, please help me win today. And I give this day to you, so you plan what you are gonna use me for today. And every day, don't let it go to waste. And have that determination of everything, in everything. Like, whether you studied, have determination of passing the test, not just, you know what, I don't care. That's every teenager's. And we think passing the test is not a cool thing, but there's no cool thing on earth, because everything, every day there is new cool thing. Every day there is new awesome thing. Every day, every minute is changing. There's no cool thing, and that is not determined. Like, there is no concrete thing that says cool thing. And studying doesn't make it's not a cool thing. But because of that, you reach that passing the test goal, you're gonna feel good about yourself, saying, oh, I passed the test, I made it. I made it here. I made it with God, thank God. And then try to set another goal for your life. And little by little, you're gonna see how much success you're gonna make, how much you can enjoy little goals that you make. And then later on, your mindset is gonna get bigger and bigger. Like last time I said, expanding your mind, your thoughts, it's gonna just get bigger. And as you reach little things by little, goal by goal, your mindset is gonna think, I can do this. I can do this with God. If He's here, if I can succeed in these things, why can't I not do big things? Then your mind is gonna get bigger. Your goal is gonna get bigger. And then by then, later on, you're gonna see that, wow, I did all those things through Christ. And the Bible just said that. the Bible say everything for you. And reading the Bible and praying to God every day in your normal lives is gonna help you. And this is the thing I want to tell you guys. Be devoted to God. Be dependent on God. And be determined on your life. Have determination of your goal. And have that mindset in your mind. And everything that you do, let God control you. Let God control your life. Let God control your plans. Let God tell you what you have to do every day. Your problems, your situation, everything. Just ask God for help. And if you're not believing me, then try it yourself. Trust me, there is a big difference. And everything's gonna work out in the end with God. So I want to tell you guys, be devoted to God. Be dependent on God. And have determination in your life. Thank you all for listening.